LCS parents, it has been a few weeks since we've done a Thursday Thoughts for a number of reasons. First of all, Christmas break, and then just the busyness of the school year has precluded me from doing a video the last few weeks. Lots of meetings as well. However, I wanted to make sure I connected with you this week because there's a few things I just want to remind you of. As I do in almost every Thursday Thoughts, I just want to thank God because without Him, none of this would be possible. We've got students on campus every day. Learning is taking place. The Spirit of God is here on this campus every day. And amazing things are taking place, and it's all because of God's goodness. We just want to thank God for all the opportunities He's given us, all the open doors He's given us, and we know that there are more coming throughout this school year. So thank you, God. I also want to remind you about next school year. That's right, we're already talking about next school year, 2021-2022 school year. During this time of year, we've already done a lot of planning for next school year, and that will continue all the way up until next school year. That's what happens in the second semester every year. And I bring that up because starting in February, we've got preferred re-enrollment. Now, let me preface this by saying I don't know exactly what next school year is going to look like. I'm assuming we're going to have students on campus. We have students on campus now. President Biden has said within the first 100 days of him taking office, he wants kids back in school. So I'm assuming that by August that things are going to look a little bit more normal, maybe not completely normal, but I'm assuming we're going to have kids on campus and in classrooms with direct instruction taking place. I do not know what kind of protocols we'll have to have, and more importantly, I don't know how many students we're going to be allowed to have in every classroom. Obviously, this year we reduced the number of students in each classroom in order to allow for more distancing within the classroom for those students. I don't know what next year will look like in regards to that. I bring that up because February is preferred re-enrollment for students that are already enrolled here at our school. U.S. families get the first dibs at those spots for next school year. Also, I have already had a number of meetings with families that are interested in next school year, and I just checked my calendar, I've got a lot more lined up. So we do have a lot of new families interested in enrolling for next school year, but again, you as families that are already enrolled, you have first dibs of those spots. That's what preferred re-enrollment during February is for. So you can make sure you have first dibs on those positions within the classroom. However, in March, we start open enrollment. That means anybody can enroll at that point. So if you want to make sure your child has a spot in the classroom for next school year, you're going to want to apply and re-enroll in February before open enrollment starts in March. All right, we'll have more information about that coming out in the weekly newsletter that comes out each week. Make sure you guys are getting that email. Lots of good information coming out there. I'm also going to try to include in that newsletter coming up a link for a website called Right Now Media. If you're not familiar with Right Now Media, you need to be. Right Now Media is essentially, it's described as the Christian Netflix. It's got all kinds of great programming on there, from adults to little kids. They've got devotions on there. They've got documentaries on there. They've got short movies on there. They've got cartoons for younger kids on there, like VeggieTales and other Christian cartoons, things like that. It's a fantastic resource to have. I use content from that in classes all the time. I've used various devotionals and various programming from that on our youth retreats and things like that. So lots of good resources. And because Fairfield Christian School has a subscription, we're allowed to share that with everybody who's also a member of Fairfield Christian School at no charge to you. So if you already do not have an account through Fairfield Christian School, make sure you get one. I'll provide that link, the invite link, in our weekly email as well. All you have to do is click that link. It'll take you right to the invite through Fairfield Christian School, and you can sign up for an account for Right Now Media. And again, it's going to blow your mind how much fantastic content is on there. They often have live seminars and conferences on there as well. So again, great Christian resource for the entire family. Make sure you check that out. All right. Whew. It has been busy here at the school. A lot going on in terms of in the classrooms, in terms of the protocols and keeping things safe around here. Obviously, we wish we could do more. I wish we could have various events and things here on campus. We can't do that. We're hoping and praying that things get better and better as we move on, and that by next school year, we can have more things here on campus, more events, more interaction between the students, more interaction with you as parents here on campus. We're just praying that God continue to heal everything. Not just physically in terms of the COVID virus and all that sort of thing, but to heal our nation as a whole. We've got a new president coming in. I know there was a lot of talk of unity during the inauguration yesterday, but as a Christian, I pray for unity all the time. First, unity between me and God, but also unity among us as believers, that we come together in unity and that we can help heal our nation. Because quite honestly, a government is not the answer to our problems. Government will never be the answer to our problems. Jesus is the answer to our problems. So as Christians, we need to come together in unity in Jesus Christ. And as we not only pray through Jesus Christ, but activate our faith in the world through Jesus Christ, we'll see a difference being made in our world. The kingdom of God will come down to earth. More people will get to know Jesus Christ through our efforts. And that's the whole point, right? We want to introduce more people to Jesus so that when he comes back, we take more of them with us to heaven. So pray for unity within our country. We're still a great country, but we still do have problems, and those problems do need to be addressed. So as Christians in unity, we need to come together and pray that Jesus help us address those issues and problems. That's what we're talking about and praying in the classroom with the students. We've had some very interesting discussions in the classrooms lately on all sorts of topics, but we definitely want to be praying for unity through Jesus Christ amongst all believers so that we can have a bigger impact on the world. All right. Hope you guys have an awesome weekend. God bless.